From birth to death, many important events of their life are connected with astrology. I will give one example. Suppose that in the Sigala Sutta, when Buddha was going along the road, he saw that Sigala was worshipping the six directions. But he didn't say that, you are doing something wrong. How can you get rid of the calamities from the six directions by worshipping them? But he said that, okay, but there are some things to add from Buddhism. You have to do this practice in this way. While worshipping the eastern direction, you have to perform your duties towards your parents. While worshipping the southern direction, you have to perform your duties towards the teachers, etc. You know, like that, astrology can be taken as a proper instrument to communicate with people and send a message to them.
Ayubuan, I'm calling a celebration in Sydney, welcoming you to this special webcast celebrating the astrological new year. This program is brought to you by Lotus Communication Network and Attodeep in association with the International Buddhist Confederation. Perhaps many of you may not be aware that millions of Buddhists and Hindus celebrate the new year today, that is, on the 14th of April every year. Let me wish you all a happy new year, and also a happy new year to you, Manjushri, who is joining me from Kolkata in India to bring you this program.
Namaskar, I am Madhusri Choudhury from Kolkata. A very happy new year. Today in India, in West Bengal, we are celebrating the Poila Boishak, that is the Bengali New Year Day. So let me wish you all in Bengali tradition, Shubho Navo Borsho. This new year is celebrated by the Hindus and the Indic Buddhist civilizations across Asia because its origins are in the science of astrology and going back to the ancient times, much before the time of Buddha. This is the month of Bak according to the Buddhist calendar and the month of April in the Christian calendar. Astrologically, this happens when the sun moves from the house of the species to the house of the Aries in the celestial sphere. When this occurs, the new year dawns. This again marks the end of the harvesting season and coincides with one of the two instances when the sun is above the equator, making this month the hottest month of the year. And perhaps in Southeast Asia in particular, people call this as water festival, as people used to splash water on each other. We now bring you a special greeting from Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya, Secretary General of International Buddhist Confederation. He will be joining us from Delhi.
Desa Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhasa Buddham Saranam Gacchami Dhammam Saranam Gacchami Sangham Saranam Gacchami. A very good morning to everyone. On behalf of the Global Buddhist Community, International Buddhist Confederation, IBC, Lotus Communication Network, and Attodeep, I take this opportunity to extend warm greetings to all venerable masters, nuns, upasakas, upasikas, and to everyone who are celebrating this auspicious day, the festival called Sankranti or Sankrant or Sangrai and Sinhala New Year on 14th April 2021. I wish you all a very happy, healthy, prosperous, and gracious New Year 2021. We have seen 2020. 2021 should be a very good, meaningful, and full of hope and aspirations for all of us. Once again, I wish you a very happy Sankrant and New Year, which is celebrated across Southeast Asia. Thank you so much.
Vasiyange aayu veden kai rata purama avurudu sirimen balan neravadu mal
amma se mangalle gamate villa
nilara shiyan hemi hita meshara shiyata paminena
Special dance bringing you greetings for the new year came to you from Impress Dance Studio in Sri Lanka and was sung in Sinhalese.
As I've already said that today in West Bengal we are celebrating Poila Boishakh, that is the Bengali New Year Day. To celebrate this festival, Attodeep is going to present a dance theatre based on the cultural heritage of Bengal titled Epar Ganga Opar Ganga, that is the river Ganga that is lying in West Bengal, in India and Bangladesh. Bengal is a land of festival. People are so fond of celebrating festivals that they used to celebrate more than one festival in every month of the year. By Bengal, we mean the portion of Bengal that is lying in India as West Bengal and our neighboring country, Bangladesh. Epar Ganga, Opar Ganga has reflections of the age-old Bengali traditions to greet the Bengali New Year. And you will see how the female artist of Attodeep has been dressed in the traditional way of wearing the sari, the male artist in their traditional dhotis and fatuas and panjabis, and also you will see all the decorations and props in their ritualistic symbols like banana leaves, swastik symbol, then the Mongol gods and the mud lamps. This production has excerpts from Chariyagiti, the first ever poem songs composed by the Buddhist Sahajya Siddhacharyas or monk gurus, and ending up to the modern poets like Rabindranath Tagore, Nojrul Islam, Abbasuddin, Achindya Kumar Sengupta, with a wide range of folk songs from Moymonsingha Gitika, Monosha Mongol, Bhatiali, Bhavaiya, Baul Fokir, and many others. So now we bring you Epar Ganga Opar Ganga by Attodeep. Mm-hmm.
to dream river deep inside their heart. River Ganga, a symbol of India's culture and civilization, is more than just a river. To them, she is the mother and the divine goddess. Epar Ganga, Opar Ganga is all about the strong bondage between two nations, India and Bangladesh, connected by this river, associated in myth and reality with the people of Bengal. Ancient Bengal was a center of Buddhist learning, art and imperialism. When Buddhism began to decline in different parts of India, it took its last shelter in Bengal. Indeed, Buddhism is the basis of Bengal's cultural and linguistic heritage, as the earliest poem song in Bengali is Chorjapadur, composed by the Buddhist Sahajiya Siddhacharyas or the monk gurus.
Amar prane O maya amar prane bajaye bashi.
With the evolution of time, the songs of Chorja gets intermingled with the soil and soul of riverine Bengal and became the songs of Bengal. The mystic singers, that is, the wandering minstrels of Bengal, the baul, fokir, darbesh and shai, preserve this ancient and fascinating Indian tradition, Chorjapado. Nagar bahire dombi tohar kuriya chhoi chhoi jahoso brahmon nariya olo dombi tohe sanga koribomo sanga
phalguno dol purnimay mridulo mithamo bai phulo bone phuloke de dula tumi januna.
Bengal is a land of festivals, of which Poila Boishakh or the Bengali New Year Day is the most popular, celebrated around 14th April in India, in West Bengal, and in South Assam and Tripura, and also in Bangladesh, respective of religious and regional differences. Bengal, Assam and Tripura, we greet people with Shubho Navobarsho, Happy New Year.
Ai mor din jaye bhabote, ai mor din jaye bhabote, Roshiya bondhu ashibar kotha, Boishakh bihu রশিয়া বন্ধু আসিবার কথা বৈশাখ বিহুতে বৈশাখের বসন্ত কালে হাইর গাছের পাতা নরে বৈশাখের বসন্ত
Upar Ganga has reflections of the glorious cultural heritage of Bengal.
মোহন রে মোহন
আমরা যেন এই আকাশের চোখের দুটি তারা, আমরা যেন এই আকাশের চোখের দুটি তারা, মাঝখানে না কুচি আছে থাকুক গে পাহারা, দুয়ারে খিল টান মেরে তাই খুলে দিলেম জানালা, ওপারে যে বাংলাদেশ এপারেও সেই বাংলা।
কবর জিয়া রে তে তুমি কে যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায়, কবর জিয়া রে তে তুমি কে যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায়, আমার সালাম পৌঁছে দিও আমার সালাম পৌঁছে দিও নবীজির রোজা, কে যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায়, কবর জিয়া রে তে তুমি কে যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায়, হাজিদের ওই যাত্রা পথে দাঁড়িয়ে আছি সকাল হতে, হাজিদের ওই যাত্রা পথে দাঁড়িয়ে আছি সকাল হতে, কেঁদে বলি কেউ যদি মোর সালাম নিয়ে যায়, কেঁদে বলি কেউ যদি মোর সালাম নিয়ে যায়, কে যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায় যাও মদিনায়।
আমার স্তোত্র পাঠ তোমাকে ডাকে, তোমার আজান আমাকে খুঁজে বেড়ায়, আমাদের শত্রু সেই এক যারা আমাদের আস্ত মস্ত সোনার দেশকে খণ্ড খণ্ড করেছে, যারা আমাদের রাখতে চায় বিচ্ছিন্ন করে, বিরূপ করে, বিমুখ করে, কিন্তু নদীর দুর্বার জলকে কে রুকবে, কে বাঁধবে বাতাসের অবাধ স্রোত, কে মুছে দেবে আমাদের মুখের ভাষা, আমাদের রক্তের কবিতা, আমাদের হৃদয়ের গভীর গুঞ্জন।
Who is a veteran scholar of Buddhist studies and Buddhist history. In Sri Lanka, the festival is called the Sinhalese and Hindu New Year, and it is accompanied by 3 days of national holidays. Both the Sinhalese and Tamils have been celebrating this New Year for centuries.
Mahavansa speaks about a festival from King Pandukabhya's time, that is about 400 BC. But we can say it's like Yakka chief Chittaraja and getting gods and humans to dance, according to the Mahamas. But we can't call it the New Year. But about the person who speaks about the New Year is Robert Knox for the first time, much later, that is in during 1992 to 1815, Robert Knox's time, and it is there in his and historical relations of the island of Ceylon. After that, before that, no one speak. Now we had a lot of visitors like Hun Sen, Marco Polo, Vasco da Gama, and all these people. But none of them spoke about our New Year festival. The main thing is based on astrology. Travel of the sun from the house of Meena, house of fish, to the house of Mesha. That's 1 year. That is the whole main idea. The same thing is celebrated on the same day by the Sinhalese Buddhists as well as Hindu Tamils. It's the same festival, but the auspicious times are different. They have their own auspicious times, and the Sinhalese Buddhists have their own auspicious times. I would rather say now it has become a village festival. It's very, very popular in the village, not so much in towns and cities. So it's very, the villagers take it very seriously. That is, they clean up their houses well ahead, several weeks ahead, and clean up the houses, do the whitewashing and all that. For weeks and months, I would say, they prepare for the new year. So it's very much a very joyous festival in a way. And people take it very seriously. Very, very seriously. In the villages, they have a lot of merrymaking, meaning they have among the children different games and all that, and among the adults different games, competitions, and still it's very, very lively. Auspicious time is, of course, everybody observes that. Auspicious time. Time for cooking the meal and for time for eating the meal, then exchange of gifts is part of the thing. Exchange of gifts. Then there's a time also to go visiting relatives. Mm-hmm. It's much there. Even in urban areas, it is there. One of the main things that is taken very seriously in the middle of the house. Even in the living room, they put three bricks, make it a place to do the cooking. Put milk in a small bowl, and then put fire, and it goes out until it goes out of the vessel. You boil it, so that is, it means prosperity. The kiri and milk is also something very significant. Milk is something that you respect as a kind of food and all that. It's still very much lively and very much a living kind of festival.
As Dr. Hema Gunatilke explained, the New Year is celebrated in a very lively manner in Sri Lankan villages. With the help of the Sri Lankan National Network, ITN, we now bring you snippets of these celebrations from villages and provinces. ITN did an 8-hour live broadcast, switching from village to village during the day, covering the festival. These snippets are taken from such a broadcast in 2019.
රටපුරාම අවුරුදු සිරිමේන් බලන් නිරබදුමල්
අක්මාසේ මංගල්ලී ගමට ඇවිල්ලා
නීලරාශියෙන් හැමිහිට මේෂරාශියට පැමිණෙන
හිරුදිවිඳුගේ මංගල්ලී මීන් බලල්ලා
සිතගේ පැතුම් හිටුවේ නුවගේ සිනාවේ
සිරිල පිපිරි ඌරුදු සිරිමේ
සිතගේ පැතුම් හිටුවේ නුවගේ සිනාවේ
හොඳයි මෙන්න තරගේ ආරම්භ වෙලා තින්නේ වටේ පිටේ ඉන්න කට්ටියත් පරිස්සම් වෙන්න ඕනේ මඩ වීසි වෙන්න පුළුවන් ඇඟ පුරාම ඒ නිසා හොඳයි එක දිගට එක පැලට ඔව් ඔව් ඔව්
උරුපැදීමේ තරගයේ දෙවන අදීරේ තරංකරුවන් ඉතා වේගයෙන් Tamanගේ ඔරුව අසුරන ආකාරය
තරගය ආරම්භ වෙනවා නිමේෂ දෙවන වටේ අපාතාර ඉන්නේ නැහැ දිමුතුගේ හලාවත කණ්ඩායම ඉන්නවා දම්කොටුවේ රන්තරු කණ්ඩායම ඉන්නවා මේ තරඟ දෙකම කරට කර
මේ රන්තරු අයට කෝ අප්පුඩිය රන්තරු වෙඩුවෙන් කෝ අප්පුඩිය ශක්තිය පෙන්වන මොහොත ආන මඩුවේ මේ හතර දික් භාගයේ ඉන්න කාන්තාවන්ගේ දිරුෂි ශක්තිය තමයි මේ අපි දකින්නේ දූවිලි වලාවන් අහසට නැගෙනකොට කවුද දිනන්නේ
හලාවත දිවතුගේ කණ්ඩායම මේ පාර දිනන්න උත්සාහ කරනවා
කරාව තමන්ගේ ප්‍රතිවාදී කණ්ඩායම අරගෙන එන ආකාරයක් අපි දකිනවා කෝප කාසියක් නැහැ සුළු මොහොතක්වත් ගිමන් හරින්න මේ පිරිසට
उद्योग අතීතේ පොතරන් භාවිතා කරාද මේ සියල්ලක්ම අපිට පුරුදු පුහුණු කරන්නේ වයිමංගම් කල ආයතනයේ
මංගල්ලේ සූර්ය මංගල්ලේ
A traditional Sri Lankan drum that comes into prominence during the Sinhalese New Year celebrations across the country. It is usually played by a group of women seated around the drum. During the New Year festivities, village teams compete against each other in Rabana competitions. This Rabana performance comes to you from Saru Community Media in Sri Lanka.